All right, hello and welcome to bmclounge.com. This is Lounge Fever, a series of videos dedicated to answering your questions. Now, question for today came in as a comment on one of our videos, and it is about the difference between project charter and statement of work. Are these two documents the same? Are they poles apart as shown in the picture right now, or are there any similarities between the two? All right, let's get into it. Now, the first thing to understand is project charter is one of the very first documents created in any project. So develop project charter is actually the first project if you see the PGKA mapping. So project charter is definitely one of the very first documents created in any project. But if you see statement of work, it sounds like it is also something which is created at the beginning of the project. It is stating the work, right? So what's the difference or what these two basically are? Let's talk about them. Now, statement of work is typically a contractual document that outlines in no uncertain terms. And I'll pause here so that you can read this again and take a look at this. It is a contractual document. And it outlines in no uncertain terms, so some legal language is also being used in the definition of statement of work. It contains the high-level scope, schedule, and cost of services that your organization will deliver to the client. So you are part of an organization that is delivering certain services, products, or any deliverable to a client. And this is the contractual document between you and your client. Now, this is mainly used externally by the company. So your company is basically using SOW externally. Mainly it is being used externally. So whenever a company takes up a new project that consists of providing a product or service, the SOW includes all the details for the client and service provider to be on the same page. So what it means is, whenever your company is taking up a new project, you are going to provide the SOW document so that you and your client can be on the same page. So when you provide the SOW, you're going to include or whatever we are going to include, let's take a look at them in the next point here. So SOW may contain business needs. SOW will contain the overview of quality of the intended deliverables or the products or service, whatever it is. It will contain schedule, but depending on the type of engagement, let's say the type of engagement here is providing human resources for 6 months. So there's no schedule as such. It's just 6 months of human resources being provided. It will also contain what is included or not included in the project, which is basically a scope, and it will also contain high level cost. Before we move further, I'd quickly like to remind you, if you're wondering what books to buy for your PMP preparation, go to pmclounge.com/resources. That's where you'll find our favorite books listed. Now let's talk about project charter. And by the way, we have already discussed project charter in the past. I'll share a link in the description below. You can go check that out and refresh your memory about project charter. So project charter, it is a formal document. It authorizes the project and give project manager the authority to spend the project budget. So two, three things to understand about project charter is it is a formal document. It is not a legal document, right? So it is a formal document and it authorizes the project. So the project is beginning. It is kicking off the project basically. And it is also giving project manager the authority to spend the project budget. So two, three main major functions of project charter we have just discussed. Now, what does project charter include? So it will contain the project purpose or the justification to do the project or the high level business needs. It will contain the project objectives or the quality characteristics. It will contain project success criteria, high level requirements, high level schedule and budget, name of the project manager. This is extremely important. It will contain list out the project approval requirements and approval authority. Who all are going to approve that the project is being kicked off or the project should start? That is also listed in the project charter. Now, a quick thing to note here is certain items which are being highlighted now, these are also present in the SOW. You get that? The business need, the high level objective or the quality, right? or the requirements, schedule, budget. These are the kind of things which are also available in the SOW. So how come we have two different documents now? And is SOW any which way connected to the project charter? So let's rewind to the develop project charter process. So this is the process where you create the project charter, and the inputs in this process are project statement of work. The first input itself is the SOW. So in the develop project charter process, the first input is the SOW, and it makes total sense because the points that we highlighted in the previous slides are present in the SOW. So those points, that content is coming into the project charter only because of the SOW. Then you have business case, you've got agreement, EEF, OPA, and these are also inputs in the develop project charter process. So what does it boil down to? Both of these documents are pretty similar because the content is actually a lot of the content is actually the same, right? Not entirely the same, but a lot of content in the project charter is taken from the SOW, because SOW is an important input in the create project charter process itself. Now, what are the differences? The major difference between these two is that project charter is typically not legally binding agreement, right? This is not something which is used externally. This is SOW has an external nature, and that is why it is legally binding. It may be legally binding, but project charter is not legally binding. Project charter specifies who is managing the project and has the decision-making authority, whereas you will not find the name of the project manager in the SOW. So these are the two points that differentiates project charter and SOW from each other. So we are also looking into a sample question, which you may find in your PAP exam or in your mock exams as well. So you're the project manager of a software project. A colleague challenges your authority to make decision to purchase a software development package. Which of the following document would you use to show him the authorization you have? So the situation here is a colleague has challenged you, your authority basically, because you have made a decision to purchase a software development package. So what document should you show him to make sure, so that to prove that you have the authority to make that kind of decision, right? That kind of authority you already possess. The options are a risk register, work plan, statement of work, or the project charter. The answer here is project charter, because project charter is where it is mentioned that you are the project manager. It is the proof of your authorization. It is a formal document. It kicks off the project and it allows you to spend the project budget. And it also clearly states your name as the project manager. So that's all that we had in this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, do hit the like button, hit the bell icon, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. If you have any such question, drop them in the comments. We'll definitely get back to you. And if your question is good enough, we'll create a video on it just like this one. Don't forget to check out the website pmclounge.com, your number one free PMP resource.